Hey, hi, I'm IT PhD, and today we continue our adventures in C language. So this is our Roguelike game. We have main function and two other functions. It's dungeon and movement. So this is our movement, and this is our dungeon. It might be different from what I showed in the past, so that's why I'm showing to you. Let's today first of all improve it, and then we would add some additional stuff like generating enemy goblin, which we will find. So how it looks here? It looks like this for now. So we want to generate an enemy, we want to generate our player and enemy in different places, we want to show score, we want to generate room in different place, and we want finally to generate several rooms. So let's do it today. First of all, I want to optimize a bit everything, make more universal, because right now you see our dungeon, it's always fixed size 30 by 120, which is bad, because for example here we have it all right, you see, but some other terminal, it could have different size. So we want to use not these values, but to get values from get max yx n curses function. We already have it, and it's kind of printed to us calls and rows, but the problem is to be able to fill our array, our map array. To do so, we need to, there are two ways to make it kind of global like we did, but the problem is that you can't do it like this. So you can't write here y and x, because if it's global array, it should be, we already need to allocate memory to it. Yeah, so we need exact size. One of the possible solution will be to make just a pointer, yeah, and then you could kind of dynamically allocate it. But I think for now let's make it more simple way. So what we will do, first of all, we would make an array, we would initialize it a bit later. So for example here, and we would say that okay, we have rows calls array like this. So we initialize our array, and then we will pass it to the dungeon. How to pass array? The problem is that we have two-dimensional array, and one-dimensional array, it's very easy to pass it. You just pass the pointer for the first element of array like this. Watch my video about it. In the past I explained this thing. And but two-dimensional array, there is a trick. So you can, yes, you pass kind of pointer to the first element, but then in the function, what you should do here, you should accept here, like define that you accept not just one pointer to this array like this. It wouldn't work. Yeah. So you see, it do not kind of understand that we have two-dimensional array. So to define the two-dimensional array, when you pass it to the function, you could do it in different ways. But for example, you can do it like this. Like we pass a pointer here, but it has certain amount of certain amount of elements in second dimension, and this number of elements you kind of pass it here. So it's how you could do it, one of the example, and it's kind of good way to do it this, because you learn like about pointers, and you see that it's pointer with some additional elements. Okay, now let's test it. Yeah, I forgot rows. And also we have still problem with the movement, because in movement we also pass this array. So for now, I think the best way it's, yeah, we wouldn't have a lot of stuff in the movement, so we would just kind of use one function. I think we would get rid from this first function. So we would have one function, and this stuff will go inside of this function here. Yeah, just it's kind of more logical not to do it, not to overcomplicate things. So we'll do this, such construction. Now everything works almost. So what's the problem? So to understand this problem, I think it's time for us to put our project to code blocks. Do you remember in my past video I showed you how to set up code blocks, and such errors like we have right now, which do not give us a lot of information. Okay, so we see here that we have kind of we made some mistake which we can't really comprehend easily. It's the easiest way, it's to debug the project. So we create a new project, console application, C, a project name Goblin, and we will put it to dot code blocks. Next. Next. Now let's, I showed you in the past how to add here a library, how to link it. So let's do it again. So you see, he wouldn't see the library, of course. So we need to link it. Let's do it. So I'm going to GitHub. Not GitHub, but tools. So I use Cygwin right now. Lib and curses. Okay. And now we need also, of course, to show where to find, to show compiler where to find header file. Tools, Cygwin, user, include here. Okay. Here you see I forgot to specify that we need not MinGV compiler, but Cygwin compiler. I just forgot about it. Cygwin. Okay. Yes. Okay, yeah, it works. And see, actually here we do not have this problem. Yeah, you see? So here it works all right. While in our file here it doesn't work. It's pretty funny. So the problem is, yeah, I understood it almost instantly, that of course we need to add additional element to array, because array start from zero. Yeah, that's why if it starts from zero, if we would have like 120 elements there, it will be from 0 to 119. Yeah, and when we pass it here from 0 to 119, so as we have rows, so our rows it's 120 rows, while we have array, we had array with maximum element 119. That's why we have overflow here in this array. Yeah, because we kind of compare it with 120 rows, while we fill here with 119. Yeah, so when we have it, we have such element of array, and it's still kind of smaller than number of rows, we again increment it, and we're trying to push here, we're trying to push to 120th element of array, which doesn't exist, as our array it's maximum 119. Yeah, so it was this mistake. Why we had it here and we didn't have it here, it's a good question. I think maybe this compiler is kind of maybe this IDE. I'm not sure even why it's so it's very strange. Maybe I think this terminal here, maybe it's different. So here it might have kind of different number of rows than here. So we could even print it, because it's quite interesting thing. So let's print it. Let's print it here. First 3120, and let's print it here. I do not know. Yeah, it's some stuff. If you know, please write me in the comments why here it works all right in the IDE. Maybe because it's allocate memory in a special way, so you kind of wouldn't overflow. But even though it has some you see warning, so let's take a look which warning it has. C may be uninitialized in this function 52. Okay, it's yet another problem, by the way, because we kind of pass uninitialized value to the function, and here we do it too. So let's make it like null, like this. And let's check it, so we wouldn't have this problem. I still like to use Notepad. Yeah, because I like dark theme, and in code blocks there is no dark theme. It's quite critical for me. But still, if we already made the project, so why not? Yeah, I think now it's all right. No warnings. Let's save our project and close it and continue to work in our favorite place. So now let's make our dungeon generation better. First of all, this one we will leave like this, like it is, because it's kind of useful thing, because we fill our database at first with some values. Later on we will add checks, so we would need an initialization of the database, but we would need to do it kind of once. So let's say that we have a global variable. It will be even like a bool, and to use bool variables we need include stdbool library, so it will be kind of init, we would say init, and by default it will be zero. So after we would make it for the first time, if init equal to zero, then we want to make it like this. Yeah, so we would initialize everything with walls only once. And after that, we will use actually checks for our database write on, which is nice. Now, we draw such a kind of crude room. So let's make a room better. Let's make room generation more legit, and let's make it randomly generated. So let's go. Let's start with a let's generate our character at random location first. Yeah, to do random generation, we need to include stdlib.h, and we need to make a random seed, and we will use function time. So check my video about random number generation. Let's write which functions we use. Okay, it's kind of bool type and then curses. Okay, so everything will be in order. So now let's generate our character in random position. First, let's create another flag. So it will be bool, like p placed, player placed flag. And initially it will be 0. So here, if player placed equal to 0, then we should place our player for the first time. So player has y and x coordinates, and we would randomize them around by number of our rows and rand by number of our calls. The thing is that we will do it in a cycle until we would get while our coordinate isn't equal to wall. And after we did it, we wanna make our flag done. So let's try it. Okay, doesn't work. No, it should be vice versa. Yeah, okay, you see now it works. So we generate our character in random spots of the room. So now let's go back to the room building. We want now to make a room, to generate room in different places too. So we can generate our player in different places. Yeah. So now let's generate a room in different places. We would have the same flag, like we have player placed, num room placed. So we would say if room placed equal to 0, then we generate our room, and at the end we make it a room placed. We do this flag because we want to do it only once. For example, if we wouldn't use this flag, then each turn, after each action which we perform, like move up, down, everything will be kind of random our character will randomly jump around. We do not want to do it. That's why we make this flex. And to place a room, we would generate location for the room, random location. So it will be Ry and Rx. It will be room coordinates. Yeah. Let's go. So our Ry will be equal again. We could just take it from here. It will be kind of the same cycle. First of all, we need to put just a random place on the screen, but it shouldn't be too close to the border. And it shouldn't be on the border too. As we do not want to put it on the border, we make it start not from 0 but from 1. Yeah. And also, we do not need to care about empty spaces. We should do it like while, and it's not Y but Ry and Rx. While Ry, so I think, yeah, we would do it even differently. We would use actually maximum coordinates of our. So, for example, if we would want to put a room, this dot here, it wouldn't make good room too. So we need at least move like 3 spots from bottom right corner. Yeah. That's why we would make it like -3, -3. And we perform our cycle a lot of times until our numbers will be more than 1. Yeah, like Ry or Rx. If it's less than 1, like 0, if it's 0 or less than 0, then roll a new number. Yeah. So that's why we do not need to care about if rent will be 0 or some negative value. We'll just regenerate it. And here we go for our Y will be Ry and our X will be Rx. So while our Y cycle will be less than our Ry. And we need also, yeah, we need size of the room, by the way. Yes. We need size of the room. So we generate, let's write it. Room point, and now we need to generate room sides. Mm-hmm. And generating room sides is actually even easier because we do not need to care about like cycle, but we need also variables, global variables here. Later on, we would put them to structure. It will be more compact. So let's call it room size Y and room size x. So room size y, we now want to make small room, but it should be random. Like, let's, it will be like up to 11, but start from not 0 but 1, and our x will be, let's make it 22. Yeah. And then here, so we found the point, it will be our top left coordinate of the room. So we need to increase it until size of our room, until ry plus our size. Yeah, like this. So let's check. Yeah, it's just a typo here. It should be replaced, not replace. Okay. And our rooms now generate in different places, which we like. The problem is that our character now kinda weird. To fix this problem, we need actually to add filling our screen, like refresh screen each time. Because here, when we put something, we do not regenerate it. We need to add like new every time, we need to redraw everything. And I wanna start with kind of removing this init, so we would use just room placed flag. So because if we placed our rooms, we already performed our initialization, we made it, so it will be enough. We do not need to overcomplicate stuff, and also we do not need to actually draw anything. We need just to fill our database for checks. Yeah. So let's make it. I'll just use this cycle here to draw our rooms. So each time we should draw them, and we would use very simple thing. We would check if our database has on this particular spot empty spot. If it has empty spot, then we would draw it like this. Okay. And of course we should actually use this thing. I copied it from wrong space. It's kind of very common thing to do, common mistake. Copy it only from proper space. Okay. Yeah, and actually, of course, we need to fill everything with just regular stuff. Yes, finally, okay. Yes, we did it. Cool. So now we have our room generated in random place. You see? Which is not bad. Okay, that's it for now. And the next time we would place also, we would generate a goblin, which we will chase. And we would make several rooms generation, so plenty of stuff coming. Hope to see you. Comments. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.